Hello everyone, welcome back to my maths class. Today we are going to discuss about the topic Basic Geometrical Ideas, chapter number 4, grade 6. As we all know, geometrical ideas are reflected in all forms of art, right? Measurements, architecture, engineering, cloth designing, etc. You observe and use different objects like boxes, tables, books, the tiffin box you carry to your school for lunch, the ball with which you play, and so on. All such objects have different shapes, right? The ruler which you use or the pencil with which you write are straight. The pictures of a bangle, the 1 rupee coin, or a ball appear always round, isn't it? Here you will learn some interesting fact that will help you know more about the shapes around you. Let's get started. Have you heard about the term points? It might be familiar to you all. By a sharp tip of the pencil, mark a dot on the paper. Sharper the tip, thinner will be the dots, right? The almost invisible tiny dot will give you an idea of a point, isn't it? When you draw a point, it determines a location, right? You can see on the screen, when you draw a point by using a compass, the tip of a compass gives a point. When you draw a point by using a sharpened end of a pencil, it will give a point. The pointer end of a needle also gives you a point. If you mark all these 3 points on a paper, you will be required to distinguish them, right? For this, they are denoted by a single capital letter like A, B, C, D. Okay, point A, B, C. This is the way to read these points. Then, of course, the dots have to be invisibly thin. You will be able to identify many such examples in our daily life. For example, a star in the sky also gives us an idea of a point, right? Okay, that's all about the points. Then mark any 2 points A and B on a sheet of paper. Try to connect A to B by all possible ways, all the routes. Then what is the shortest route from A to B? You can see a line, right? The shortest join of point A to B, including A and B, shown here is a line segment. It is denoted by line segment AB or line segment BA. Here the end points A and B are called the end points of the segments. Okay, then we can conclude that a line segment corresponds to the shortest distance between 2 points. Then can you tell me what is a line? A line is obtained when a line segment like AB is extended on both sides. You can see on the screen line segment AB. I'm extending beyond A in one direction and it is enlarging, it's expanding beyond B in another direction without any ends. You may get a model for a line. That is called a line extends forever in both directions, then it is a line. And a line segment is a part of a line that is bounded by 2 endpoints. Then what about the third one, rays? A ray is a portion of a line actually. It starts at one point called a starting point or initial point. It is fixed and goes endlessly in another direction. We have the line segment, both ends are fixed. We have the rays, one end is fixed, the other one is endless. And what about the lines? Both ends are endless. It is not at all fixed in both ends. See, in the screen you can see some examples for rays. Their one end is, the original point is fixed and the rays are coming from that particular point and that directing to a endless point. So one point is fixed, another point is endless. Okay, let's come back to the lines itself. We have mainly 2 types of lines. One is intersecting line, other one is parallel lines. If 2 lines here, blue and red lines, have one common point. They are called intersecting lines because they are cutting each other at a point. Then if these two lines making an angle 90 degree, then they become perpendicular lines. Now we have another sets of lines, blue color, red color on the screen. See, they never meet each other, right? Lines like this which do not meet are said to be parallel and are called parallel lines. They never intersect each other and the distance between these two lines always same for a particular parallel lines. Railway lines, the opposite edges of a ruler scale, the crossbars of the windows are always parallel. These are the practical example for parallel lines. That's all about points and lines. Hope you all understood this. Thank you for watching.